And we're back. So, in our last episode, we lost a little ground to the Parthians, but we pushed back Palmyra a little bit, and I'm hoping that... Oh, Palmyra's gone. Absorbed by Rome. So that's another front not to worry about. So with the Romans coming up here, up against the Parthians, I think that'll give us an edge. Let's rally the slaves a little more. Maybe get a rebellion going so that they pull their troops back. Oh. Let's increase his rank. Let's do Paragon. That'll reduce the cost of actions. I do want to push back against them, but taking Cappadocia would also be a nice bonus. So after this technology, I'll be able to recruit a dignitary, which will allow me to see what's going on there, and if I should attack. I'm not particularly worried about Mazaka over there, as long as I can take our Samosata back from them. Ready. That's the important orders. Thing.
Ready for battle. Ready for orders. Ready for battle.
The horse corrals would be a nice thing to have in Armenia, so I think we'll go for that. It'll really improve our cataphracts there.
We fight for you, my lord.
Oh, we can upgrade our troops. I totally missed that.
My lord.
I'll just focus on the cataphracts for now.
At your command. We fight for you, my lord.
So I think...
Ready for orders.
We'll do a little more recruiting here to improve Ubar's army and maybe send him. No, actually, let's recruit some Persian cav for Artaxias and a couple units of hoplites. I think that'll really give him a much stronger group there.
At your service.
And Orodes doesn't see anything going on here. Let's move him back to Ekbatana.
Can I assist you further?
They don't have too much going on.
I cannot do as you ask.
I think this was this decision of having really huge cities on the map. At first it was very jarring, but on second thought, it's they're graphically nice, and you can kind of see what's being built, and if there's construction going on in the city at a quick glance, and you can kind of see how cities actually were, where they had the wall, they had more of the settlement spreading out outside the walls, which is a nice touch. So it's not all bad. Okay. I'd say that's enough for this turn. And the Parthians are upset about my agent there. It looks like nothing happened.
Mm-hmm.
Ah. Let's see. A member of your family is having an affair with her Greek physician. What a shame. Let's punish. 'Cause the affair is bad. Bad for the family. But I don't want to get rid of her forever. I mean, she's nice at parties. Good conversation.
We fight for you, my lord.
Okay. So let's recruit a dignitary. Sharukin. Oh. Sargon. That'll be nice. Frada. Dareavahu. Darius. Let's have a magus named Darius. How about that? That would be ironic.
It's an honor to serve you. Making my way.
We'll send him to our Samosata to scout out.
Ready for
make
battle.
Sure everything's on the up and up. The Parthians do have an army coming to Gazaka. Oh, and there was an objective here. Research technology in construction. Let's do that. Quarrying. Okay. Might as well complete the task. I think with our garrison we could have a shot at beating the Parthian army there. So what happened here?
My lord.
Can we kill this target? It's possible. It's possible. No, we don't have to do anything. Let's just keep subverting.
I will teach them. My power knows no bounds. My lord.
Recruit. Let's just swell the numbers a little bit.
Ready for battle.
Yeah, I'm not that invested in Gazaka and Fraspa. Mostly just the Armenian provinces up here. Once I can unite the province and make an edict, that'll really help us out, I think. And then I'll focus everything on pushing back. Okay. Of course, we also have to keep an eye on what the Romans are doing. Make sure Antony doesn't get too powerful before we challenge them. All right, time for a fight. They have a lot of cavalry, but we have hoplites, so if we can... Yeah, let's fight. Let's fight in the town. So if the enemy stays back and uses a lot of javelins and arrows, we probably won't be able to beat them. But if we can bog them down in melee with the hoplites and the axemen, hopefully my archers will be able to whittle them down, kind of. Though I am concerned about the cataphracts, if they can flank me. So we've got a nice little town here. Enemy is all crowded up there.
Parthian archers!
So let's put our archers up there.
men!
We are at your command!
We'll have the hoplites and hillmen over there.
Axemen!
Actually,
men
no.
Of Persia!
We'll have the hoplites in the back.
Axemen! Persian
no, this will be better. I want
melee
the...
infantry at the ready.
If the cavalry engages in melee, I
Persian
want the hoplites to be at the front. And then the axemen can kind of charge in from the back. All right.
Spears ready!
Do not be mistaken, men. We have the advantage here. These pretenders and their ambushed levies play at battle like simple children. We do not.
Persian archers!
Let's actually have the archers in the front there. Or at least in the mix here so that we can start firing quickly.
Infantry at your command!
Persian hoplites!
Hillmen!
Our orders!
You can fire at any time, guys. Okay. Okay, the horse skirmishers are coming in.
Archers!
What exactly are you doing,
quick
archers?
March! We await your orders!
No, what are you doing?
At
stay
speed.
Back there.
Persian hoplites! Hillmen! Engage!
Have the hillmen engage.
Persian hoplites!
Does hoplite wall help against missiles? Yeah, I'd say
organize
so.
Organize yourselves!
Archers!
Oh, my lord!
Pick your targets!
Awaiting orders!
Yeah, if we can keep them bogged down here, that'll really help out. Okay, their javelins are really, really hurting us. Their cataphracts are kind of having a party over there.
Axemen! Persian hoplites!
Yeah, they really want to take out the hoplites. Hopefully, if they charge now, the hoplites can kind of take out a few of them.
Axemen! Hillmen! Axemen!
Cataphracts.
We are at your command.
You can scatter. Scatter at will, archers.
Axemen! Elite archers!
Double time!
Okay, archers, just stay there and keep firing. Take out as many of them as you can. The big thing is, when the Parthians have the cavalry advantage, it's hard to do anything against them. They are losing men. Just not in great numbers. We might as well turn off skirmish mode since they're cavalry, so they can just run us down. Archers are really at least doing some damage. I don't know exactly what the Parthians are doing. The cataphracts have their backs turned. That's very brave of them. This is not the best display of the AI's prowess. Well, I'll just stand here all day. They're not even in range to fire back. Yeah, they're gonna scatter. Okay.
Ready to march!
So, what do you want, Parthians? You can either come or I'll wait all day for you. I'm not gonna engage those cataphracts if you don't want them to. Oh, I see, they're firing with the horse archers. They've taken out 6 of my archers. Yeah, they're not even firing. I don't know what's going on. Okay, so they're gone. Now there's only these guys to fire at, but I guess they don't want to. That's okay. Oh, they're coming in. Oh, they're gone. Okay, so what exactly... Okay, we've got 30 minutes here. And I don't know what the Parthians are thinking. I'm afraid to activate their cataphracts because... But on the other hand, it's not fair if I win with the AI being stupid. Our morale isn't that bad, all things considered. Well, let's just see if I can fire on them. Come on, guys. Keep firing. No, they really don't want to do anything. The elite archers are out of ammo. Okay, so keep firing. Wow. So, the AI broke and lost. Oh, I don't want to save the replay. Yeah, that was very strange. I don't know. The cataphracts just didn't want to engage. I guess somehow the AI calculated that it would put their general in grave danger, so they decided, we'll just turn our backs and have their archers fire on us, and that'll be safer. So, yeah. Yeah, I probably didn't play it right by having my hoplites get torn to pieces by javelins, but that was really strange. Yeah, 248 kills for the Persian elite archers there. Strange battle for Gazaka. Let's get some income. Yeah, so all the Parthian armies seem to have pulled back here to Ctesiphon. Oh. Well, Artaxias just has to...
Ready for orders.
...improve his gravitas by fighting some nice battles, I guess. Okay, let's see what Darayavahu can come up with here.
As you command, my lord.
They got nothing.
At your command.
Let's take it. They have no allies.
We take this settlement for you, my lord.
Not worth it to fight. Armenia is united. I probably took too long to do that. So now we can do an edict. We want to do bread and games. That's always the best thing to do.
Ready for battle.
Darayavahu is prepared to go to Mazaka. If Artaxias can, if I make a nice treaty with Pontus to just march on through, I'd like to just take Mazaka and then leave it. And then wheel back around here to Mesopotamia with my larger force there. Yeah, I've got some Persian cav, so it's a nice army over there. We'll upgrade once I get more troops into Media. I'll upgrade the buildings faster. I don't want to upgrade too much and then lose it. Yeah, and we're getting our cataphracts next turn, so I want to save a little money. Let's do some more slave rallying. Perfect.
Ready for orders.
Okay. So the important thing is to have a lot of archers. That's what we learned in the previous battle. I don't want to have slingers. They annoy me. Let's just focus on archers. Yeah, one more unit there. Okay. We're good. I'm playing this game pretty conservatively, but haven't played in a while, and I want to at least reap the benefits of having a full, well-defended province. Yeah, I hope my friends to the north hold off those nomads.
These
There's nothing more annoying than
need
fighting horse archers.
Will your mighty armies march to meet them?
Where are the Sirakis? Oh, up there. Okay. Yep, so Ashur-Rish-Ishi took out their mage, or at least wounded him, Magus. Ah, so Parthia has lost a satrap. Which is good for us, since they have less allies. And it seems like the Kidri are... They took Charax, which... is right in the center of Parthia's power, so that's a good thing. That's probably why they pulled a lot of their armies back. Alright, so Artaxias, since he's united the province again, he is the new King of Kings. Yeah, so I do worry about Kartli or Artan losing, and then I have to fight a war on the north. That would be really annoying. But not much I can do at the moment. So we have tax inspectors there. Yeah, not bad. Good for the food situation. So let's make some cataphracts. So we can have cataphracts, noble blood cavalry, or Azat knights. What's better? Azat knights have more melee defense and melee attack. So it seems like they also have maces, swords, more than just spears. But the cataphracts have better charge bonus and armor. I'd say let's make some Azat knights. It'll be nice to have a horse unit that's great at charging, but can also stick around in melee nicely. So let's do 2 Azat knights, and then I'll have cataphracts for my other generals. Once I have the money to recruit them.
We fight for you, my lord.
Let's get some basic hillmen there. And then we'll move Artaxias down south, probably. And we'll have Daryavahu check out the situation here in Mazaka.
I shall rest a while. I am your champion, my lord.
Not enough money to do that this time, but that's fine.
I leave for the war.
As you command, swift and silent.
Yeah, not much going around at Ekbatana, so we'll
as
check out our Sakya next turn.
On the move.
And I hope to build up these 2 armies and move them, one to kind of be on the defensive and one to attack. And take Ekbatana, or maybe just have them both attack. Alright, next turn.
Have not omens shown that
the
Gauls
will welcome
a defensive
alliance.
Treaty?
Perfect. As long as they don't fight with Pontus, that'll be a good move for me. Okay. So let's choose a tech to research, and then that'll probably be the end of this episode, after doing some scouting around. Weapon proficiency, that's a nice one. Siege would also be nice. Especially since the Parthians do have quite a few armies. So let's improve our siege technology. Yeah, let's do the siege technology. Okay, so Artaxias has two units of Azat Knights, so he's ready to go. We could improve the infantry of his army.
Ready for orders.
Or even have some cataphracts. Yeah, I'd say that's a good idea. Let's give these horse skirmishers. No, it's good to have light cav. Let's give these eastern spearmen too. The purifying flames here. And in fact, let's give them the other two. And the slingers. And for Artaxias, let's give him some archers and cataphracts. And then we'll recruit some hoplites and axemen. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty good.
I am your champion, my lord.
Let's raid Ctesiphon. Failed, wow.
There is a fine line between failure and fate.
Okay, so I'd say we'll continue next time and we'll invade. Oh.
My words.
Let's check on Mazaka.
As you command, my lord.
Yeah, the Cappadocians are not doing well. So I could send the purifying flames to put them out of their misery. I might do that. I'll see if I can go through Antony's Rome to do that here. Maybe this way. No, this way's okay. Okay, that'll be enough for this time, and next time we'll attack Mesopotamia and maybe take Ecbatana. See you then.